Hello everyone, I'm making this tutorial to share the 3D model that I will be using in my Santa Jajam game. What is Santa Jajam? It is an ongoing GBT game jam ending this Christmas. You have to build a Christmas game with the name Let It, followed by your own word or phrase. More details in the description box. At the end of this tutorial, you are able to get something like this, and you can further develop your model with what you have learned from this tutorial. Let's start with the first step, planning. I usually start with the design. First of all, I need to pick the character that I'm going to use. I pick a Personodon. Second, I start with the first object to connect to the Personodon as a base. Then I start adding more pieces to the model. At this step, I also think how I want to rotate the joint. Step 2, let's head back to GBT and add a character. Start with the Personodon. In the settings, only keep solid so that it can walk on the ground. Add a game screen camera so that we can see the model no matter where I am in the programming screen. And I add left right stick movement to test if my model can move or not. Step 3, let's add 3D shapes. At this step, I have to look at my plan. And first, I add a cylinder to be a torso. In settings, only keep visible and movable. Change connection point to be from center to center because it should appear at the center of the Personodon. Also adjust the size to your liking. Don't forget to connect this to our Personodon. Now we can see a floating cylinder, which is our character's torso. Next, I'm going to add a head, which is a sphere. Again, only keep visible and movable. Keep the connection point to be from Y negative to Y positive because it is on top of the torso. Yay! Now we have a body and a head. Next, let's add legs. We need to add a box between those two legs so that the legs won't stick together. Again, only keep visible and movable. Set connection point to be from Y positive to Y negative so that it will be below the torso. The box is too deep. Let's reduce the size on Z axis. Next, I'm going to add a sphere, which will be a hip joint. Set a connection point to be from X negative to X positive so that it will appear on the side of the box. Now we can see our hip joint. Let's add a leg next. Our legs have to swing front and back. In other words, they have to rotate around X axis. So here I'm adding an X hinge connector to support the rotation. Adding a cylinder to be a leg and connect it to the X hinge connector. In the settings, keep visible and movable connection point from Y positive to Y negative because it has to be below the spherical joint. Now you can see a leg that can swing back and forth. The leg is a bit too long, let's adjust it. But before we continue, I have decided to add a face so that we know which side is the front. It's still too long, so I will just keep adjusting the length. Now that I have found a suitable lens, let's make another leg. Simply copy all the parts from the spherical joint to the cylindrical leg. Change the connection point of the copied sphere to be from X positive to X negative. Yeah, now our model has two legs. I'm going to add the shoulder part next. First, I have to add the hidden green box as shown in the right. So I have to add a box with connection points from Y negative to Y positive. And to make it clearer to everyone, I'm going to remove the visible property of the spherical head. And now you can see a box on top of the torso. Next, I'm going to add her collarbone, which is below the previous box. So add another box, connect it to the previous box, and set connection point to be from Y positive to Y negative. And make it blue so that it is easy for us to see. Make sure it has the same width as the torso because we do not want the shoulder to be inside the body. Now that we have the hidden collarbone, it's time to add her arms. For this tutorial, I'm going to simplify the arm part by not making it swing. So we will need only Z hinge connector instead of two hinge connectors. Let's add the shoulder joint, copy the sphere and connect it to the collarbone. Make sure that the connection point is from X negative to X positive. Now that we have a shoulder, let's add an arm next. We have to rotate the arm piece around Z axis, so let's add a Z hinge connector. The base of the Z hinge connector is the sphere which our arm will rotate around. Copy a cylinder and connect it to the Z hinge connector. Now the arm is moving crazily. Let's fix its movement. Go to the Z hinge connector's settings and limit the range. Now the arm will stop moving. If you want the arm to move a bit, you can change the range. Let's add another arm. Simply copy all the pieces from the sphere to the cylinder. Connect the sphere to the collarbone and change the sphere's connection point to be from X positive to X negative. Notice that the arm swings to an incorrect side. We have to update the Z hinge connector range. Update the range to be the negative value. And now we have got two arms. Finally, she has got all the body parts. The most common problem of the 3D model is the bone snips. So how shall we fix this? To show how bad the bone snip is, I'm going to add a button B to make the Pteranodon jump. We can see that the model keeps bouncing after each jump. Let's fix this. The basic idea is that instead of connecting all the objects to the person, we will teleport those pieces to the Pteranodon. And so, let's remove the connection between the Pteranodon and the Cylindrical torso. Go to the Pteranodon, add a teleport exit, and connect it to the Pteranodon. In the settings, teleport physics must be reset, and ensure that the connection point is from center to center. Next, we have to teleport our 3D model to the teleport exit on the Pteranodon. I prefer to teleport a fancy object instead of a cylinder because in the future, you may want to teleport other objects. So here, I'm using a soccer ball as a base. And then I connect a cylindrical torso to the soccer ball. Add a teleport entrance. In the settings, remove visible and make sure that we are teleporting a soccer ball. However, it seems like our 3D model is possessed. I did not touch my controller, yet my model still moves forward. So let's fix this by going to the soccer ball's settings and remove the solid property. And now our model will move smoothly, because there is no collision between the ball and the person. In this step, we are going to make walking animation. To make the model walk, we need to send the anchor values to the X hinge connectors at the leg. We need to know if the model is working or not. We can check that by reading the value from the left stick control. Add a counter to keep the current state of the walking cycle. We do not need the direction of the left stick output. Add absolute value to make sure that all values will be positive. Send the absolute values output to counter's count up. In the counter settings, change mode to be bounce and count range to be the range of the leg's angle. I set the range to be from negative 20 to 20, but you can adjust this to your liking. Send the counter's output to one of the legs. And now you can see one leg moving when she's walking. Let's add a movement of another leg. When one leg moves forward, the other leg has to move backwards. In other words, when the angle of one leg is 20, the angle of the other leg has to be negative 20. To achieve this, I add an inversion nodon and connect the counter output to the inversion input. Send the inversion output to the X hinge connector of another leg. And yay! Now both of the legs move correctly when our model is walking. In the last step, we are going to complete Akajan's head. Here I have already prepared all the textures with different faces. resize them to match the size of the spherical head and connect it to the sphere. I have put all the texture faces here as a reference. Finally, her head is complete. You can continue adding more textures and more pieces to your 3D model. Have fun making a 3D model! Lastly, I would like to thank Bomberaj for writing a 3D model guide and Mr. O for teleporting technique used in step 4. If you want to see more advanced 3D models, check the fighting game by them that I played in my live stream before. And bye bye and see you soon in the next video or live stream. See ya!